Good afternoon once again. Welcome to Electrochemistry. I'm Teacher Bernard Ocheng. Today, we want to look at the factors that affect the preferential discharge. What is supposed to be discharged at the electrode? One of the factors that affects the preferential discharge is the position of that chemical species in the electrochemical series. In this electrochemical series, we have this electrochemical series. If you start from this one, this is potassium. This is the quantity of electricity that is past the electrical potential required. And then, if you move down the series, we have up to silver. This is for the cations, the positive charged ions. And then we have the anions. The anions, this is the electrical potentials for them. Now, if you look at this electrical potential, you will be able to know which cation can be easily be discharged given the electrical potential. The ones that are lower in the electrochemical series are always discharged because they have the ability to gain electrons. They have the ability for them to gain electrons. Unlike potassium ion, which hardly accepts electrons, silver can easily accept electrons. So the position of this electrochemical species can easily tell using this electrochemical series, which cation is likely to be discharged. The same applies to anions. The ones that are high above in the electrochemical series tends not to be discharged because they hardly lose electrons, unlike hydroxide ions, which easily lose electrons to form oxygen. So the position of this chemical species, you'll be able to identify, you'll be able to know that indeed this chemical species can be discharged and this one here cannot be discharged. Another factor that affects the position, affects the what is supposed to be discharged, is the concentration of electrolyte. We learned in our previous lesson, like we had an electrolytic cell where we had one with concentrated sodium chloride and the other one with dilute sodium chloride. With the dilute sodium chloride, we realized that at the anode, oxygen was produced. And with concentrated sodium chloride, we realized that at the anode, chlorine gas was produced. And in that case, why was chlorine produced? It was produced because it had relatively high concentration compared to hydroxide ions. And that is the reason why chlorine was discharged. So another factor that affects the whatever is supposed to be discharged is concentration of the electrolyte. When it comes to the nature of the electron, number three, we also learned in a previous lesson that if you have an electrolytic cell where we have a copper, two sulfate, and copper electrode, the products are not the same when you use an inert electrode, for example, graphite. When you use graphite, the product is not the same as when you use the copper electrode. So another factor that affects the preferential discharge is the nature of the electrode used. So in this case here, a good example was given in a previous lesson using copper electrode and also using graphite electrode. The products are not the same. These are the three factors that affects the preferential discharge. Electrolysis is very important. We always apply it to obtain certain materials in certain reactions. We want to discuss the applications of electrolysis. Now, one application of electrolysis is electrolysis is used in the extraction of reactive metals from their metal oxides. Extraction, number one, extraction of reactive metals from their molten oxides. These include, for example, sodium. Sodium is extracted through electrolysis. It's a very reactive metal and cannot be extracted through reduction. We also have magnesium. Magnesium is another reactive metal, cannot be obtained by just reduction, but through electrolysis. Aluminium is another metal that is obtained through electrolysis. So one application of this electrolysis is used the process used in the extraction of reactive metals, for example, these three, there are others. Two, we have electroplating of metals. Electroplating of metals. What is the meaning of this? Electroplating here refers to coating one metal with the other. The reason why metals are being electroplated, there are two reasons. One, to prevent corrosion. Two, is to enable the article to look attractive, to look very attractive. Now, for example, if you have, we always know that we have, for example, silver, gold plated watch. These watches that people do put that appears like gold, but indeed they are electroplated. They are electroplated in the sense that they are coated with other metals. For example, it can be an iron which is coated with gold. And when it is coated, it makes the article to look attractive. That is one problem. And this one here can be done if you put an electrolytic cell, and if this is the electrolytic cell, and then we have the cathode is the watch that you want to electroplate. This is the watch, and then from here you use, if you want to electroplate this gold, this electrode becomes gold. Gold is Au, and this could be iron. So once the Au, this solution must be made up of Au ions. Now the gold ions will be able to coat this particular watch, and this is the way this watch will be electroplated, and it will look more attractive. Another application of electrolysis is sacrificial protection, or what we call cathodic sacrificial protection. Sacrificial protection. Now, what do we mean by sacrificial protection? A metals which are high above tends to be oxidized than metals that are low in the reactivity series. What do we mean by this one here? For example, if we have a bridge, you know, bridges are made up of ions. The beams are made up of ions. If this is a bridge, and then this is a beam made up of iron. This iron, we know that iron will rust when it's attacked by oxygen and possibly water from a water vapor. It can easily rust and destroy the structure of this metal, and therefore the bridge will collapse. Now, to ensure that this bridge does not collapse, this iron can be connected using a connecting wire, metal, for example copper, to a magnesium block. This is magnesium block. Now, this magnesium block, what is the role of this magnesium block if this is the bridge and it is connected to this magnesium block using a copper metal? This will prevent this iron from rusting. Now, magnesium is high above iron in the reactivity series, and therefore, this magnesium, the question is, how will it protect this iron from rusting, from corrosion? This magnesium, being the fact that it is high above the reactivity series, now instead of this iron to react with the oxygen and water, it will be magnesium to react, because magnesium is above it. So magnesium will become oxidized first, magnesium solid will become oxidized to form magnesium ions by releasing the electrons. And by doing this, iron will be protected from corrosion or from rusting. And that is one way of, we call it sacrificial protection. Another way of protection is through galvanization. Galvanization is where iron sheet, for example, the iron sheet that we see around here, what we see is not actually iron, it is zinc. In the sense that the iron is coated with zinc, such that if this is iron, like this iron sheet, and then when electrolysis is done, zinc will coat it. Zinc metal will coat it like this. Now this zinc will prevent this iron from rusting. That is the reason why. Now this zinc will protect iron from rusting in the sense that instead of iron to react with oxygen and water, it will be zinc to go to the solution. So zinc solid will go to solution to form zinc ions by releasing two electrons. And this, by doing this, it will protect iron from rusting. Another one through sacrificial protection, I mean another application, number four, is what we call purification of metals. Purification of metals. Purification of metals. We learned that copper can be purified through electrolysis. You get the pure copper, you put it the anode, and the pure copper, you put the cathode, the anode at the cathode. So now the copper ions will be attracted to the cathode and they will pick electrons and they form copper atoms. And that's how the copper atoms they will be deposited and you will obtain your pure copper. That one you learned in your previous lesson. Thank you. The remaining part of application, we are doing it in our next lesson. Thank you. Let's meet next lesson. Thank you.